people have to live in unity.
We are still in transition.
Civil society has been decimated.
Of course we rely on media.
And I think the government has not done enough.
The international community has failed to respond.
No place in the world is perfect.
I'm your host Lipakshi Khurana with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show. As the festive season set in India, the country found another reason to celebrate this week. It was the momentous occasion of inoculation of 1 billion COVID-19 doses, only the second country after China to achieve the feat. While everybody around the world lauded the Indian achievement, the government paid a special tribute to the doctors, paramedics and the healthcare workers by holding several events, including the illumination of all UNESCO heritage sites with national flag colors. Have a look.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi oversaw a vaccine inoculation as India crossed the mammoth mark of inoculating 1 billion COVID-19 doses in the country. With a target population of over 940 million, the country has already jabbed over 70% of them with at least one dose and around 30% with both the doses. Experts around the world say that the feat cannot be termed anything less than historic, for the country had to fight massive challenges, including those of initial supply shortages, vaccine hesitancy, logistics and supply chain challenge, and the rumors and propaganda spread by competitors and the players with vested interests. Modi said that the 1 billion mark had provided a strong shield to the country, and the fight was only going to be more intense in coming days.
Aaj 21 October 2021 ka din इतिहास में दर्ज हो गया है। भारत ने अब से कुछ दूर पहले ही 100 करोड़ वैक्सीन डोज का आंकड़ा पार कर लिया है। 100 साल में आई सबसे बड़ी महामारी का मुकाबला करने के लिए देश के पास अब 100 करोड़ वैक्सीन डोज का मजबूत सुरक्षा कवच है।
India, the second most populous country, is the first democratic nation to have achieved the mark, with indigenous manufacturers confident of producing the next 1 billion in the next 3 to 4 months. The global community has lauded Indian efforts, saying that not only the Indian numbers will help contain the spread, but they have set a benchmark for others too. New Delhi, however, has said that it is not going to grow complacent and will ensure that the entire country is fully vaccinated as soon as possible. India has so far reported 34.1 million COVID-19 cases, most of which were reported during the second wave of infections of the Delta variant between April and May. The number has come down significantly since the vaccination drive picked pace.
बहुत बहुत सही है. एक्चुअली ये बहुत जरूरी भी है क्योंकि सब वैक्सीनेटेड रहेंगे ताकि सब मतलब सेफ रहेंगे. वो तो बहुत जरूरी है.
Pictures of healthcare workers celebrating the occasion also did rounds on social media, and the government acknowledged their contribution by paying a special tribute to them. From iconic Red Fort in capital New Delhi to several world heritages were illuminated with the national flag color to mark the occasion.
उत्सव ही है ना हमारे लिए कि 100 करोड़ डोज हो गए. उससे भी बड़ा उत्सव ये है कि आज मुंबई में, महाराष्ट्र में या देश में कोविड को इतनी अच्छी तरह कंट्रोल सबकी मेहनत के वजह से हुआ है.
While India has emerged as one of the fastest in inoculating its adult population with COVID-19 jabs, even faster than European and American countries, it is also set to come up with vaccine for as young as 2 years old. Indigenous Bharat Biotech has already made the announcement and the vaccine will be rolled out in a couple of months. The government says it is committed to protecting all its citizens and the country has grown self-sufficient in doing so.
Moving on, India is bracing up for all eventualities that might prop in the face of a growing Chinese aggression in the region. Beijing has already been endeavouring to alter the status quo at several points along the line of actual control, and that too based on its unilateral assumptions and ambitions. And while New Delhi has scaled up its weaponry procurement in the last few months, it has now established an airspace control centre in its northeastern state of Arunachal Pradesh to enhance its battle preparedness.
A boost in its military might has remained one of the key focuses of New Delhi in the past few months, especially in the aftermath of a clash between the two sides when India lost its 20 soldiers while China did not disclose its real casualty figure. In the line of the same strategy, an airspace control center has been developed in its northeastern state of Arunachal Pradesh. Like Ladakh region, China has been notoriously and periodically infiltrating here too. Indian Army, however, says its aim is never to provoke anyone, but to enhance its defense system and remain battle prepared. The newly inducted system will help India keep a strong vigil on Chinese movements.
This is a new raising brigade for the eastern sector, which has just come up. We are just about 6 months old, and we have established our core airspace control center for the first time in the forward area. And we have enmeshed ourselves with the field formations and all our assets are now totally integrated with the field formations.
Since last year's clashes, India has moved troops to its eastern stretch of the border. Experts say that the Indian state of Arunachal Pradesh, which China, in line with its expansionist agenda, refers as South Tibet, could once again become a flashpoint. China's propaganda on the Tibetan region is also based on a retributive agenda against India, as it gave refuge to the Dalai Lama and the Tibetan government runs in exile from Indian territory. It has further been rattled by increasing number of anti-China protests being carried out by Tibetans in India, demanding freedom from the clutches of China. And while on one side China has illegally occupied Tibet and aims to occupy even more, the Indian side has endeavoured to resolve issues amicably. Several unsuccessful rounds of talks have held in the region.
ये वो location है जिसको हम New Maitri Sthal कहते हैं, जहाँ पर हम खड़े हैं ये conference hall है, जिसमें Bumla की location के अंदर करवाई जाने वाली border personnel meetings को अंजाम दिया जाता है. Covid से पूर्व यहाँ पर 9 border personnel meeting हुआ करती थी, जिसमें से 5 भारत की तरफ और 4 चाइना की तरफ हुआ करती थी।
The current geostrategic turn of events, however, suggests that China is not in position to launch any aggressive action against India. Not only several countries are opposing its expansionist agenda in the South China Sea, but a rapidly deteriorating situation with Taiwan, coupled with the United States' increasing presence in the Indo-Pacific in the form of Quad, which also involves India, has pushed it on the back foot. And in such a scenario, any irresponsible and unilateral step could prove counterproductive for China and its army along the Indian border.
Moving on, Afghanistan and Taliban have been the two buzzwords in South Asian discourse for the past 2 months. While the Taliban has been tirelessly defending its violent and regressive mode of operation, the world is worried about a rapidly deteriorating human rights situation in the country. Whether it was the Moscow summit on Afghanistan or the NATO defense ministerial meeting this week, the top agenda was how to bring stability, both social and economic, in the war-torn nation. All of them have unanimously urged Afghan leaders to mend their policies, but the group has brazenly put forth its position, saying everything was going as per the law in Afghanistan. We'll also show you how all their claims fall flat in face of a growing resistance from women demanding equal rights and employment.
Afghan women holding placards reading that they were part of the society and education and employment were their rights took to streets of capital Kabul this week. The outrage broke out in wake of the Taliban's exclusionary decisions that have barred them from education and have restricted their personal freedoms. It's been over 2 months since Taliban gained control of Kabul, but the older girls have still not returned to schools. Under the current Taliban dispensation, not even one woman is holding any office. They have also been barred from being employed in a large number of professions. And while it is a clear violation of the terms Taliban agreed to during the peace deal, its leadership during the recently held Moscow talks in Afghanistan, which was also attended by regional players, including India and Pakistan, maintained that the government they were heading was not just inclusive, but deal-abiding too.
Government is in Afghanistan now also inclusive. About 500,000 employers working with us. All of them former employers.
At a time when the United States' withdrawal has left a massive vacuum in an unstable Afghanistan, Russia, which according to many experts is also concerned about a potential terrorism threat emerging out of Afghanistan, appealed nations to provide financial aid to the Taliban in order to provide it a chance to prove itself. Moscow has also urged the Taliban to endeavor for inclusive government, which is representative of both its political and ethnic diversity.
Противодействие вышеназванным угрозам безопасности Афганистана и окружающего его региона, равно как и угрозам, которые проецируются на другие регионы мира, требует своевременного, адекватного ответа как внутри страны, так и со стороны внешних партнеров. Мы призываем движение талибов, и об этом только что говорили снова с уважаемой делегацией, строго следовать линии на недопущение использования территории Афганистана кем-либо против интересов третьих стран, прежде всего, конечно, против непосредственных соседей Афганистана, стран Центральной Азии, наших друзей и союзников.
Taliban, however, has clearly denied, at least as of now, that it is changing anything in the manner in which it operates. It said it would create conditions for women within the framework of Sharia law, the sole component which the global community is apprehensive about. Since returning to power, the Taliban say they have moved as quickly as possible on opening up their government and guaranteeing rights to women and that they do not represent a threat to any other country. The US and the other NATO countries are not ready to believe the Taliban on face value, and hence the money they could have directed for the people of Afghanistan has been barricaded. Repeated Taliban appeals have gone unheard, for they haven't changed anything on ground.
كذلك اكثر الدول كل دول هم قالوا وبصوت واحد تقريبا ونادوا على امريكا ان تنتهي تحذيرات ماليه لافغانستان ولا تجمد اموال افغانستان لان هذه الاموال كان للشعب الافغان وكانوا ياخذون منه رواتب فلذلك لا حق لهم هم
Meanwhile, the lifestyle in Afghanistan is deteriorating with every rising sun. Whether it is low-income group Afghans, daily wage earners, or even big entrepreneurs, all have been severely affected. And it is not just about the women's rights. The Taliban is failing at every front. While it couldn't control the sudden fall of markets and is unable to provide salaries to its employees, it has received major setbacks at the security front too, with ISIS regularly and increasingly targeting civilians.
And now in our section of Asia this week, the stories from across the continent that hit the headlines this week.
Four months into one of its worst COVID-19 outbreaks, Israel is seeing a sharp drop in new infections and severe illness, aided by its use of vaccine boosters, vaccine passports, and mask mandates. Israel was struck by its fourth coronavirus wave in June, fueled by the fast-spreading Delta variant. Rather than imposing new lockdown measures, the government bet on a third booster dose of the Pfizer Inc. vaccine for people aged 12 and up, mandated face coverings, and enforced use of a green pass, proof of vaccination, recovery from illness, and a negative test for the virus at restaurants and other venues, even for children. Since peaking in early September, daily infections in Israel have fallen more than 80%, with severe cases nearly halved. Israel's living with COVID strategy, which has come not without cost or controversy, has kept schools and the economy open. The data show that among people over 60, the first group to receive boosters, infections began declining rapidly about 2 weeks after the third doses were administered, while still climbing among other age groups. Japan's Yokohama is an exciting and lively city. Recently, it hosted a three-month-long Dance 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 event, which concluded recently. This symbolic dance event is held every 3 years. A large number of participants gather to show their amazing performances on the stage. They are beyond the borders of age, gender, nationality, disabled, professional, and even amateur. Dance stages were set in various open areas such as Commerce Facility, Shopping Street, Station Square, and so on.
コロナ禍においてですね、なかなか活躍の場が少なくなってしまったアーティストの方々などなどがですね、しっかりと公演していただく。また自分たちが踊る場面がなくなってしまった市民の方々、市民のダンサーの方々も踊っていただくという場面でですね、見る方も楽しんでいただくし、踊る方々もしっかりとこう今だからこそ頑張れるというような公演を作っております。
Yokohama City concentrates to cultivate rich creativity and artistic ability of children. Yokohama City provides dance teachers for the school dance activities and organizes workshops to study dance techniques for the children. A group of professional freestyle football performers mesmerized the audiences. Takata Matsubura Memorial Park for Tsunami Disaster is located in Rekuzen Takata, city of Iwate Prefecture. A coffee shop cafe here sells soft ice cream, which is very popular among the visitors. Muscat Cider Soft Ice Cream is a gelato ice with muscat flavor, tastes like soda.
道の駅開業にあたりまして、 まず美味しいミルク味を提供することが、まあ、大きなテーマにありました、まあ、その目処が立ったので陸前高田らしいオリジナルのソフトクリームを神田ぶどう園のマスカットサイダーを使用したソフトクリームで、まあ、地元の素材を生かして、まあ、味に独自性のある、まあ、それでいて美味しいものというところです。
Rikuzen Takata City faced disaster during the Great East Japan earthquake 10 years ago. A huge sea wall and a memorial park are built on the seaside when the city was reconstructed. The lone miracle pine is the only pine tree in this area that was not destroyed by the tsunami, and it has become a symbol of reconstruction. Muscat Cider Soft Ice Cream was developed with an aim to roll back the time and get the town filled with tourists. The ice cream has been developed in cooperation with Nisei, a soft ice cream maker company. Muscat Cider Ice is a gelato mixed with soda, not cream. The taste with muscat flavored soda has been developed by a local vineyard. This vineyard was also damaged by the tsunami, but it is still functional and produces original soda. along with the drinking soda, the local vineyard developed a sprinkling soda powder. The refreshing ice cream is very popular among the visitors. As this tsunami-hit town is fast moving towards normalcy, tourists here can enjoy Muscat Cider soft ice cream.
Moving on, apart from the beauty of the Himalayas and the richness of natural resources, Nepal is also known for its distinct culture and colorful, vibrant festivals. Over the years, the people here have not just preserved their centuries-old traditions, but have expressed them with both pride and pomp. A number of them recently gathered at ancient Bhaktapur city to celebrate a unique tradition of expressing gratitude to deities for answering their prayers. Have a look.
Devout Hindus gathered in Nepal's ancient city of Bhaktapur to mark the unique tradition of thanking gods for answering their prayers with traditional fervor. This tradition is a part of the week-long Hindu festival of Dashain that concluded recently. As part of the ritual, those taking part on behalf of their families covered themselves with a thick layer of cow dung, a natural antibacterial fertilizer which is widely used in Hindu rituals at this particular time of the year.
Yo aba aja tika ko din aba basai pichhe rakhcha yesto pahila pun 3 barsha 4 barsha agadi nai bati bagdi bhanthyo chhoro le ani yo lockdown le garera बाल्न पाएन यसपालि अब यो लकडाउन पनि अलिक खुक्लो भएको भएर मन्दिर पनि खुला भएर अनि यसपालि चाहिँ बाल्दैछु
Devotees place 3, 5, 7, 18 or even 108 oil-filled lamps on their bodies. This ritual can be performed by persons of all ages. They lie still in the same position for at least 6 hours, while the families and relatives remain on their side to not let any of the lamps go off or fall. It is believed that placing lit oil lamps on themselves brings good luck and helps them get rid of their sins.
Yo aba yo euta aasha ho hai dharma prati ko aba rahar pani ho bachar ko thulale pani balcha yo केही अब भनौँ न भगवान्सँग अब केही मागे माग्नको लागि अब भगवान्लाई भनौँ न अब एउटा पाकल जस्तै
The festival is the highlight of the religious calendar in Nepal, during which Hindu devotees celebrate the victory of good over evil. Devotees also perform dance, play dhols and use other means too to appease the gods and goddesses. Such festivals highlight the cultural treasure trove of the Himalayan nation and particularly focus on the spiritual heritage of the country.
Hinduism is the most diverse religion where some rituals are quite unusual, but they all hold a cultural and scientific significance. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.